Hello, everybody, and welcome. We've come back from Europe all the way into the Americas qualifiers here for ESL One Genting, and we're going to play a game that should have happened a couple of days ago. Team Freedom against Complexity in a best of three is kicking off right now as I can unmute my co-caster and welcome in Mr. P. I'm going to start calling you that again now. MRP, welcome, dude. Welcome, welcome, welcome. This is a game that we were meant to cast, right? Or was it me?
Yeah, it was
me and you, and then it kind of got... Kind of got pushed back. The lobby chat was interesting, to say the least. So these guys still in the quarterfinals and still looking towards that spot up against Doo-Wop in the semis. We'll have NP against Infamous as well tonight, as well as the Doo-Wop against whoever wins this game. We've got three best of threes from the Americas qualifiers, and honestly, I'm looking forward to all three of them. We've had some interesting games from the previous rounds. We've had some clowny drafts and some interesting matches. And Complexity start things off with their last rack, of course.
Yeah, I mean, something that they've been leaning on time and time again, and they picked not only in general, but against Freedom just a couple of days ago in Dota Pit. So, I mean, it was almost effortless, the last series between these two teams. Complexity taking out Freedom 2-0, and both games sub-23-minute wins for Complexity. So we'll see if Freedom can kind of pick up their socks. It was this same squad as well with Tomato and BSJ standing in for Team Freedom. So it's interesting to see if they've got something different planned here already. Going to jump into that Infest Bomb, picking that up in the first phase with the Batrider and the Lifestealer. Lifestealer, a good hero to be able to deal with the Leshrac as well and all his magic damage output that he brings to the table.
Yeah, I mean, Freedom, they look good in the series that we had in the Genting qualifiers. You know, they weren't against the best of opponents. Team Dota Master and Disciples. It was Dota Master, Slayer, Lucan, F4L, and yeah. It didn't go so well. They did lean on BSJ's Ursa and Lifestealer, you know, two of his bigger heroes. You know, previously he played a lot of Ursa and Terrorblade, a lot of Phantom Lancer was one of his big heroes, but obviously PL's not really in a good place right now.
I don't think he is a hero at this point. There was the Huskar there as well, but of course that's a little bit of an outlier in terms of strategy, not something you can fit in all the time. So yeah, his hero pool being a bit limited can be a little bit of hindering force, but at the end of the day, he does play those heroes very proficiently, the ones that he is good on. So still, I think, wide enough of a pool just in the one position to be able to work around, at least for the time being.
Yeah, absolutely right. Batrider for Alex. Mike should be good as well, while Cole go back into the Void. Man, Leshrac, Wisp, and Void, and the Wisp, I feel like they've struggled in the past maybe 2 months or so to actually find a good place for it. You know, they've got a great Wisp player. You know, Z-Freak is very good on the hero, but Wisp is one of those heroes that you do have to kind of draft around to some extent, or you have to know the kind of dynamic of where the game's going and what you can do with a Wisp, because if you're not in the right place at the right time, you know, it's easy enough to say, oh, that's a great tether, he's coming to save, but you've got to know how lanes are progressing and how the dynamic of the lane is shifting as the game goes on. Because, you know, a 1v1 lane between, you know, a Batrider and a Void at 10 minutes in one game is going to be completely different in another game. And now a Legion. Well, usually we see, you know, Lifestealer and Slark and heroes like that against the Bat, but with the press of the attack, you can actually purge off those sticky napalm stacks.
Not a bad Wisp partner as well. Overwhelming odds is actually pretty damn scary when you have all the sustain available to your mana pool from the IO. So a good nuke ability early on. It's an interesting deviation for Complexity. This is the exact same opening Leshrac IO Faceless Void that they went for against Freedom in the last fight, series in Dota Pit. And Freedom opted to try and teamfight them. They built an Undying. They went with BSJ's Ursa, as you mentioned, and they got Tidehunter. Here it looks like they're going for more of a pickoff-oriented style where they have the Batrider Lifestealer, they can cover themselves with the Global Science, they can look to disengage on the big cooldowns such as the Chronosphere of Complexity, and then look to fight with a numbers advantage. So Complexity's kind of response to that here is to pick up some pickoff power of their own. Having the duel into the relocate gives them a little bit more of, you know, a dimension to their team fight rather than just having to fight you head on with their cooldown. So I like the deviation from Complexity, but also we're showing some adaptability in Freedom's side, being able to go away from the five-man versus five-man, try and take their engagements in smaller skirmishes and be able to get objectives off the back of that.
I think also one of the cool things that we've seen in that game against Freedom previously, in that best of three, they ran the Swindles left track, didn't they?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And that's kind of a switch up because they have run Mu in the offline left track before that. So it's one of those heroes where it's still kind of open. You know, you're not sure what's going to come at you here. The Void and Legion, but you know, both can go safe lane, off lane. Legion could potentially be, you know, in the jungle, but No doubt we're going to see that this game. Not going to have a 4-roll Legion and a 5-roll Wisp. Freedom, yeah. Like I said, have got that kind of global silence to give them a bit of a safety, a bit of a safety net. Well, it depends how you use it. If it's defensive, it's a safety net. If it's aggressive, it's like that umbrella where you know, you kind of keep yourself covered and make sure nothing can stop you from killing off that one target, like the IO. But what do they do about hitting towers and actually going forward into breaking high ground? That's the big question. Yeah.
I mean, both are at least the Dire lineup is going to be a little bit hard-pressed at this point to be able to look at structures in Roshan, so that is definitely a bit of a glaring weakness in their lineup. But, I mean, you know, their constant goal is going to be just to gain a numbers advantage before they look at objectives. So they can go all in towards that basket, and I wouldn't hate it against a lineup that's a little bit more cooldown-oriented and a little bit more group-oriented and complexity side. But, you know, it remains to be seen. As you said, sometimes you just can't be able to find a pick because the other team is grouped too much. So you need to be able to at least trade objectives somewhere. And, you know, with these fighting-oriented heroes, with the Batrider and the Nyx, you're not really going to be pushing structures all that quickly. So complexity, they can just five man into your buildings and force you to fight them. And if you don't have that global silence or that lasso, that initiation tool, you know, the Vendetta with the Nyx or the Blink with the Batrider, it's going to be very difficult for you to do so, especially into the counter initiation potential of the relocate save and the Void being able to drop a chrono on you once you try and go in on them. So yeah, it's definitely something that maybe Freedom will look to remedy in this last pickup, but complexity, they've still got versatility. Either of the Void, Leshock, or Legion can all go towards the mid lane with a Wisp beside them. So I guarantee you we see two cores here, but it, as you said, they could throw the Leshock in the 4-roll, and they could throw the Legion in the jungle as well. So they're still a little bit their way in terms of variability.
Oh, man. A nice little storm band there. Pretty good with the global silence, just able to zip in, take out Leshrac or I, you know, like you're saying, these squishy heroes, as the TA was a hero complexity utilized again with this kind of lineup, and Tinker for Team Freedom, so that's going to be their kind of security as the game goes on.
I could see the Invoker here for Cancel. It's one of his best heroes. Deals decently against Tinker in the mid lane because the Forge Spirits allow you to last hit even when you're lasered. And also combos obviously very well with the Relocate and the Chronosphere from the Void. That is going to be a bit of a greedy setup from Complexity if they do opt for that route, but definitely something I could see. And Cancel, I mean, these three potential cores in the Lesh, Void, and Legion, haven't seen him play all that much. So I definitely feel like he's one of those players that feasts on a few heroes but has some work to do on others.
Yeah, I do feel you there. They've also got like Sunstrike into Duel as well, which is a great little combo that you could maybe look towards. But Team Freedom, the way their lanes are set up, how are we seeing this? Tinker mid, Nyx is in the 4-roll, hard 5 silencer, and then Batrider goes towards the offlane. Is that pretty much
that's
how they're going to set things up?
I'd say that's the most likely configuration for them. Not one that I'm a huge fan of. At some point, you see the silencer simply become a walking global silence, and he's often food. So it's a little bit risky. It's a little bit greedy. But I'd say that the trade-off, you know, losing farm on your silencer is much less risky than losing farm on a Nyx Assassin. Yeah. Nyx Assassin without farm is not a great hero. He's got great abilities innately, but he needs his levels. So I'd definitely like to see them give him a bit more.
Yeah, it feels like they've got much less leniency in how they can actually set things up, while Complexity do have a bit more leeway in how they can set up these lanes. They're taking a long old and hard think about this one, but I'm pretty sure they're all in their team house. You know, Swindles has got his final pick sorted. You know, a good 30 seconds before this, they're doing the huddle, getting themselves all pumped up and ready, and out comes the Alchemist. There we go, a hero for Cancel towards the mid lane, it looks like. So, JK, 1-roll Void, offlane Legion Commander. But I've seen good things from Timardo. You know, his play has been pretty exceptional so far. His Invoker, his Puck, they've all looked very good. He is probably a standout young up-and-coming mid laner for the Americas region.
Yeah, definitely so. He's been a little bit impressive. And the Alchemist pick, although it's a hero that can deal with Tinker mid lane in the sense he gets an early bottle, he spams out the wave, he farms some side camps in the meantime or stacks his Ancients, he's going to be one that'll get himself some farm here, and he's not too worried about a roaming silencer or Nyx Assassin. So I understand the pick in that perspective, but in the way of stopping Freedom in lane, I don't think the Complexity have much potential to do so. They only have, you know, the Leshrac stun, and that most often is going to need a setup, and they're lacking that at this point. So it is a little bit worrisome, because Freedom, once they get their level 6 abilities in the Vendetta, in the Infest, in the Lasso, they are very strong towards that mid game. And although Complexity, I think they're going to get away with the Alchemist Greed, it's going to be the early mid game that's going to be the hardest, I feel, phase of the game for them to survive once all the ultimates come out for Freedom. And it doesn't feel like Complexity really have the wherewithal to be able to bully them all that much in lane.
Yeah, and I think you hit the nail on the head there. It feels like a bit of time is all Freedom needs. You know, Alchemist, mm-hmm. sure enough, in the early mid game, he can withstand this damage. But once Tinker gets up to like level 2 Rearm, maybe his Aether Lens and Ags, or if it goes the Dagon build, then sure. But Tinker mm-hmm. and Lifesteal are both very, very good at dealing with this Alchemist. High HP, relatively low armor, needs to build into armor items very quickly. The pure, just raw nuke damage from Tinker can do a lot mm-hmm. of work against him. As Nyx Assassin just got himself a Siesta. Takes out an Observer Ward up towards the top part of the map. Batrider in this normal place, Alex Michael, hide himself in the trees just to drag the creep wave back. Nothing really Justin can do down here. But how are they actually setting up these lanes? Z-Freak as well as Swindles are actually aiming towards mid and top, it looks like. While Wisp, 3 Fairy Fires. Now, honestly, I never used to... Oh, God. Yeah, you missed that Split Earth, actually, Swindles. Yeah, this rune is going to be hard to go in for with the Arcane Curse down. Cancel dodges the stun. The Arcane... the Bounty Rune goes to Tinker, though. And now they've slowed him a fair amount. Still gets himself away, while Bounty Rune in the bottom lane does go to the Faceless Void. Awkward engagement there. Complexity losing out the fact they don't get out that Bounty.
Yeah, he skilled the Greed, and not only that, they forced to press the attack skill as well, else Cancel would have died in the mid lane. So pretty large win, it feels, in the early game for Freedom. One thing, they did go for Boots first on Jubei, so look for him to kind of throw himself at the enemy, maybe Suicide, as he's got the Courier in his stash. So they want to be able to get that Courier going sometime soon.
I'm assuming Swindles missed another stun there, and that's why Rx Mike is giving him the LMAOL. Adding another little L in there at the top lane of the battle. The Wisp is in trouble. He can tether across over to Mu here, it looks like, with the Fairy Fires keeping him alive a little bit longer. BSJ tries to get in with the open wounds and will do so. Right click attacks come out. There's another stun, and Z-Freak under his tier 1 is taking a lot of damage, but will not go down just yet. Jubei's diving in pretty deep, though. Well, press the attack will keep Z-Freak alive, at least for now. And Jubei, oh man, one more hit. That's all he needs, but Mu can't find it. He denies himself to the neutral camp.
Yeah.
Swindles continues the all chat banter.
That was the plan all along for Freedom, as I said. They had the Courier in the stash, so Jubei with Boots first, he wanted to just throw himself at the enemy, get himself a little bit of time in lane to last hit, and get back to get the Courier for his Tinker in the mid lane, who did go for the null tally first and is going to want his bottle here soon after. So Freedom are okay with it. BSJ ends up missing a couple of last hits, and we all know, you know, how much of an adamant last hitter he is in lane, how much he works on his mechanics, so that should be a little triggering for him, but he'll be fine going forward. And I feel like Freedom should be just fine in these lanes. We'll see if Jubei is able to get his levels. That seems like the biggest task for them, or the most difficult one facing them going forward.
Oh, top. Mu does get stunned up there, and in comes Eagle with the slow. It looks like
no mana for open wounds.
A few more punches in here. Mu still has that pressed attack. And you're right, no mana for open wounds. Won't be able to kill him off. Cancel was playing aggressively into this Tinker, sort of into the tier 1 tower, but he knew the Z-Freak was on his way with a bit of regen. No bottle for the Wisp, of course. Went for the wand, or the magic stick, and a bunch of fairy fires. As again, Mu's gone on here. Jubei has a stun, just trying to harass down this Legion commander. But fairy fires on Wisp, I never really used to see it until quite recently from American games. Mm-hmm. You know, from American teams, there was... I can't remember what team he was playing on. It was one of the Genting qualifiers, and he was just like buying fairy fires until like the 30th, 40th minute, just whenever he had a free mm-hmm. slot. Yep, buy a fairy fire. And now you see Z-Freak, you know, he starts with 3, he's still got 1 in the inventory. It's such a great little burst item, being able to heal yourself up in these sticky situations, and also, you know, that nice little added bit of burst regen to your teammate that you've tethered up to.
Yeah, and sometimes you overlook even Wisp right clicks. He's got a pretty good animation, so he just kind of hangs around with the tether, throws a few at the enemy, and it's a lot of value out of that item. For the IO top lane, just a little bit of jostling back and forth, and Z-Freak is over to the west with the tether ready if need be, so get a little bit extra value out of that, press the attack, but Either way, looks like for now, things looking pretty good for both sides. Cancel is a little bit behind in his mid lane and would like to have a bit of regen. Goes for the Sage's Mask for now, likely into that Soul Ring, but not going to have a bottle up against Tomato, and that should widen the gap in the Tinker's favor in this mid lane.
Z-Freak? See, I was going to say that Jubei hadn't missed a single stun until he missed one on Legion, and then, well, you can't really call that a miss. It was an attempt on the Whispers he was TPing at, so I'll give him that one. But, yeah, on the Alchemist, we've been seeing fewer and fewer Soul Rings and more of this kind of casual Sage's Mask just to give you the percentage regen with your chemical rage, which is pretty nice. But you're right, he doesn't have bottle, so it might just be that Soul Ring because he does need HP and mana regen just to try and spam out the Acid Spray, especially when he doesn't have any stacks being made up for him. You know, Swindles is trying to pressure bot lane. IX Mike has been, well, not really held to level 4. He's got another full wave with 4 ranged creeps coming in, and they've actually pushed this onto the tower to try and do some damage to him with Justin going into the time dilation. The stun lands, and IX Mike, well, he might get a taste of his own medicine as Swindles. The old chat, where is it, buddy? The pause comes out. Settings. Oh, yes, that's a clap for you. Oh, God, Kyle, I'm so glad you exist.
The mind games continue in North America.
Dear Lord.
And he even goes for the covering DC just to make it look legit. I love it. Love it all around. But as you were, you know, just touching upon, IX Mike's doing pretty damn well in the lane. That death is going to hurt him a lot more than just dying because it's almost a double wave under the tower that he's going to miss out on experience-wise. But he's fared pretty well here early on, able to drag the wave out early. And
it's just so good.
He'll be the first to call ready.
This rivalry is honestly so good. It's like a soap opera, you know. It's like one of those Spanish soap operas. Oh man, IX Mike. I don't know if he's not the hot mom. He's the one that goes after the hot moms, isn't he?
He's a mistress for sure. IX Mike is Anedota's mistress. BSJ top lane is nearby his lone zone. I mean, Eagle. Not the scariest zoning support, as Mu will just stand in the face of him and trade, but with last word, we'll at least force him out of lane. For now, Jubei, going down to the bottom lane, I like this move if he's got a point or two in mana burn, but for now, since he's holding a skill point, maybe makes a move towards another lane. I think that one of the better heroes to be able to use that mana burn on is the Void. He's not the highest in the way of intelligence, but does rely a lot on his mana for his stability in lane. So at least just going to help out IX Mike for the moment. But he's got his Tranquils up, so he's always got jungle camps to retreat to if need be.
Moo, got to be careful there, standing in a bunch of creeps, especially with a lifestealer around. Has his phase boots up.
Last word as well.
All of a sudden, lifestealer's damage, you know, increased quite significantly with the phase boots. Mu, let's slow up Jubei. They're aiming for the wisp on the back end, but Mu himself is dropping low, and with the stun and slow, well, press the attack has kept him alive with the tether as well. So much heal and sustain. Another turn onto Eagle. Oh, Silencer with only a windlace, no brown boots. The body blocks try to come through from Jubei, but he's actually let the Legion through. It's two more swipes out from Mu and Z-Freak. Well, the passive will proc, and Mu will find the kill. And now, maybe they can actually look for BSJ here. Z-Freak, has he got another Fairy Fire? One stick charge remaining, but the stun from Jubei will find the kill.
He can turn this.
And the open wounds. Slow Mu enough to keep the Lifestealer alive. In his bottom lane, IX Mike again just goes in onto Justin, but 10 stick charges, no big deal, really, for that Faceless Void. Swindle's actually swiping in from the left-hand side, but Mike's already out.
Yeah, that overwhelming odds movement speed may be more important than anything else it gave there. Just 521 MS for the Legion, able to chase down the Silencer, and even BSJ having to take a trip back to base there on the ladder end. So pretty big win for that dual lane in the offlane 2v3.
Lifestealer lost 149 gold.
Oh, I guess he didn't buy out completely then.
So much for lane efficiency.
BSJ traitor to his own teachings. But
I mean, I didn't see it happen. I didn't click on him. I just saw the fight recap, and fight recaps can bug out. So I'm just gonna add a little suffix there, saying maybe he's okay. Maybe he did the right thing. I'm not 100% sure.
Are they going to get to tier 1 in the offlane though for Freedom Side? Unfortunately, Justin not able to pick up the last hit. But either way, going to open up rotations for his supports going forward. And the Void having the Iron Talon, he's just fine. PMS as well on top of that to farm the jungle. So this isn't really a big loss to them. Just a little bit of an influx of gold And right now, I mean, they're preparing stacks just towards the mid lane for cancel that he can when he has some time out of lane. So Justin just fine to take the farm over to the east. We'll see how Tomato's doing in the mid lane, though. He's got his soul ring up, working on the Boots of Travel recipe, and is dominating in the way of CS. 46 and 21 to the 24 and 4 of his counterpart.
He's already been taking down a few jungle camps and has a little stack here remaining for himself. So I think I should have a good time. Top lane, though, in comes the cavalry. Jubei aiming that stun. Lands nicely on Zeefree. Perfect. In through the trees. He tethers himself across, but he's still in the middle of three heroes here, even with the pressed attack from Mu. Poor little Wisp is dead, and now another stun from Jubei is all they need. Mu has to dodge this, but can he? Jubei, oh, he lands it in under the tier 1 tower. BSJ, he's not got enough damage to actually finish this one off, and now he's in too deep. He's dived in. The rage comes through. Doesn't even need the split earth from Swindles to find that kill. Lifestealer. Well, that was a little bit too far.
Great reaction from Swindles. And, you know, one of the caveats there, the physical damage from the Edict. So Rage not going to save you there, especially when you're isolated, as BSJ was. So they get a little bit overzealous and give up the definitely more valuable kill over to Complexity side. So unfortunately for BSJ, that's going to be a step back. But he is nearing that infest milestone, and IX Mike already level 7 on the Batrider with a little bit less skirmishing going on in his lane, so they can get that combo up together. And you know, you lasso up a Wisp with the infest nuke damage, he is definitely dead under that duration, so should bode well for them if they're able to kind of keep the vision game in their favor.
And you're talking about levels, the Wisp just hits level 4. Relocate is a fair distance away, unfortunately. Swindles, How's he doing? He's closing on level 6, but it's not a really big point for the last rack. Pulse Nova is not really a swing item, a swing spell. Can't really start off team fights or anything like that. So likely just continue with how things are going. Farm up a little bit. Maybe try and get into those arcane boots as Justin starts off with a ring of health. And we've been seeing a fair amount more of the Lincoln's first Faceless Void. You know, we used to see a ring of health on Void, it's like, oh, he's going to go Battle lane. Fury, but yeah, you're right. The duel gets a win onto Eagle, and IX Mike coming in with the Nyx Assassin as well. In behind, Zeefreak will have to tether himself across onto Mu. He'll actually succeed as the Carapace doesn't do any damage to him. Oh no, there's no stun from Jubei. He realizes he's too far away. And Zeefreak's perfectly fine, just healing up with that bottle he's got.
Yeah, and IX Mike's rotation is to no avail. He tries to play that a little bit economically, figures he has the vision from Napalm, doesn't really want to expend the lasso for a Wisp at 48% HP, but good communication from Zeefreak and Mu. And now Tomato in trouble as well. Split Earth is going to whiff up on the high ground, though, and it does a little bit of juking in the trees. Pulse Nova's there, Edict probably to come out as well, and it does now. Flame Break pushes him back. Open Wounds is there, and now IX Mike's joined the fray. He doesn't have mana, though, or the lasso just yet, but the Firefly and the ticks from the Napalm should be able to bring down Swindles. Rockets even come through on the back end. IX Mike, though, the one to pick up the kill. Mu evacuating out towards the mid lane. Zeefreak goes for the TP, and looks like he'll be successful.
Realizes that the Nyx had followed through onto Mu. They did this nice little split maneuver where, you know, one went east, one went down to the south. Make sure that at least one of them would escape, and a great TP out by Zeefreak gets him away. So buys the Tome of Knowledge, so we'll be hitting that 6 soon, but in the meantime, we do have Justin on bottom still just continually farming, and that Lincoln Sphere on a Faceless Void, it's going to be hell to deal with, you know? As a Batrider with a Nyx and a Lifestealer, you want to be able to blink lasso, kill the Void so there's no Chrono. But once the Lincoln's up, you're going to have to choose another target, honestly, because what do you have to cancel it? You've got Last Word and Laser, Open Wounds, but then you need to pop outside of the Lifestealer to get that one out. It's going to be a tough story to sell to actually jump on that Void.
Yeah, we'll see if they have the damage to dump in. You kind of rely on your Leshrac quite a bit in that scenario. Maybe the Alk gets to the point as well where he can join the fight and throw in the Acid Spray. But Justin definitely is going to be a very difficult target to kill off with this Lincoln Spear. Whether or not they have the damage to continue to win team fights or at least take advantages early, I suppose, remains to be seen. But Jubei, he's on the move alongside IX Mike.
You're right.
With his first Vendetta, and they're looking for Cancel in this mid lane, who does have the Chemical Rage active, so he is going to be a bit of a difficult kill, but BSJ's even joined the fray. TP's are coming in as well. Lasso is there, so he won't be able to throw out the Concoction, and that will ensure that kill.
Okay.
With 5 towards the mid lane.
Okay, we said he was a difficult kill with Chemical Rage up, but if you bring 5 heroes in 12 minutes in to this middle lane, then okay, I'll give you that one. Definitely forcing down the Alchemist with everything they've got. But he's got his armlet, he's got 1,800 gold saved up, and you're looking at this now. I was about to bring up the point, the Legion was ahead of the Lifestealer in net worth. She's not anymore, but still very close. His offlane hero, the three-roll hero, is pretty much on par with your one-roll here. And yeah. Then you look at the other two, Alchemist and Void. Sure, Alc is inflated by the Grievel's greed, but it's still a great start for the Radiant, as overall they've got about a 3,000 net worth lead 12 minutes in. Experience-wise, about 1,200, nothing too significant, but this does mean that Wisp will have that level 6 and about 300 experience, which is why I think they're all moving up towards this top lane. Find the Legion, find the Wisp, the Dire scans inside the jungle. Alex Mike isn't going to go for the Wisp though. They open wounds onto Mu, purges it off, and Fairy fires up. Away he goes, there's no catching him, while Z-Freak, Tether, not available. He tried to TP. Many, many heroes though towards this top lane, as Tinker can join at any time really. Pushes out mid, tries to hold away this aggressive push in from Complexity, but honestly they've got, it feels like now they've got all the time in the world.
I've yet to see in a pro match, like Jubei dropped the stun there, but I've yet to see like the very disappointing Flame Break not cancel the TP. So Jubei there not going to be able to indulge me, but either way they will grab up the, you know, lower value kill in the Wisp. It's a nice pick for them. But again, as you mentioned, it's a lot of time where BSJ is spent kind of sprawling around looking to help out his team. You know, that is one of the powers of this hero, is the burst damage that's offered from Infest and Rage. Just that couple of seconds.
Look at where Z-Freak is. Oh, can they get here? Justin, they see him. Chrono down onto the Tinker, and in comes the damage from Swindles from the north. He actually looped in way behind with an Obs and a Sentry back towards that bottom lane. The stun won't land as the time warp from Justin gets him close to the creep wave. All they wanted to do was CS, but now he's trapped in the lasso. The global silence comes out as well, so there's no jump from Justin, and down he goes with Swindles TPing away back to safety. He did buy his Lincoln's Recipe, it looks like, on the Faceless Void. Top lane, though. They want to try and go in on the Lifestealer. Mu, he's got the duel with a Rage Lifestealer. Oh, God, that's a lot of damage, actually. They're not going to be able to get the win, but they should be able to get the kill with the final proc of that moment of courage coming through, giving Mu the Blink Dagger as well.
Yeah, and he wasn't even that lucky with the procs. He does have the level 4 press the attack, so huge amount of bonus attack speed there, helping him out in that endeavor, but only got two procs on the moment of courage, one after the duel. And despite, you know, not grabbing up the damage, it's still his second duel that secures him a kill. And not only that, it secures a Blink Dagger here 15 minutes in, out of that offlane in a 2v3 scenario. So very big pickup for there. Swindles is going to drop in towards that mid lane as the Vendetta sets up for Timado's TP in, but just a bit of a consolation prize after losing their Lifestealer top.
Yeah. They actually wanted to go in on the Alchemist, I think. Nyx scouted him out and did run around, but there was no way anyone could catch up to the Nyx Assassins. Or the distance he was ahead of the rest of his team was just too far to actually bridge. So yeah, Swindles, like you said, consolation prize there. And Complexity, tier 1 top is still standing. Tinker making sure. But at least for now, it'll stand a little bit longer, as Justin on bottom lane needs another 800 gold for that Lincoln Sphere, but he's up against a number of heroes down here. I think Complexity have seen all of this, though. Again, that deep observer ward that Kyle put down while looping around this bottom lane, as well as a sentry ward there looking for that Vendetta from Nyx. But Jubei and Eagle are already down here. Justin has he's disappeared. He's gone. Mm-hmm. He is not going to be anywhere near that tier 1, just in case he does get dived. And the pings come out saying, maybe he's in the trees, guys, but Swindles walking into IX Mike, and he's found him. The trouble is lack of damage, I think, for Swindles. Yeah. With the Pulse Nova, he might be able to find this kill before he dies himself. Oh, not quite. 20 health. Very nearly.
The other thing is he's going to tip them off to the Vision up on the hill here. And, you know, just a moment ago, you look at the Vision coverage from Swindles. He's got three wards all down deep. The one top lane near the tier 2 just expiring now. But that's great against a Nyx and a Batrider plus Lifestealer. You want to see when the Lifestealer hops into one of his comrades and looks to go a hunting. So you know that's the case, that they're, and you can pull off or group up. But Swindles provides a little bit of information and allows Mu and Z-Freak to take out the top tier 1 tower. And as you were touching upon before, when you have a Tinker on your side, you don't want to be giving up these towers. You want to be giving them up as late as possible because you're pretty good at defending them just by sending one hero. So Swindles, although he pays with his life, he does gain himself effectively a bit of map control across the way.
And Radiance for cancel as well. Buying time for this Alchemist just to get into that item. Can now look for the Boots of Travel. And that's when things start to get a little bit nasty for Freedom. You know, they've got They've got okay ways of kind of handling the Alk illusions, but dealing with the Alk hero itself? If Rage is down for Lifestealer, you know, it's going to be a tall order for them to actually get themselves up against the big man. Jubei does move up onto this top lane, but Tinker with the Blink Dagger should be able to at least control these lanes a little bit further. Is that the full Lincoln's now done for Justin? It is. And it's pretty much fight time, I think. That's a cool one. Cancel with the Hood of Defiance. Not going BOTs as his next item, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Going for the Hood against the Tinker Rockets. Batrider's annoying. Nyx Assassin's got a few little nukes coming out as well. I mean, there's little to no physical damage here from Freedom. It's the jump on top with the duel. Well, have they got the win? They do indeed. Moo, cutting it a little bit close there, but with the help of the Gloves of Haste and nearly the armor complete, Moo will do a good job.
He's 4-0-1 right now on this Legion Commander, so can look into, you know, a Maelstrom, perhaps even just a Midas for longevity in this one. But I really like the Hood of Defiance choice from Kessel. That's Chronosphere. Yeah, it's going to drop bottom lane. The TP's in are going to be a bit late for Justin, but he gets a bash on the back end, looking to find out Eagle. Lasso, though, going to keep them back. Global is there as well. Eagle does drop to the last right click. Legion is taking down to this Firefly. Able to back out, it's canceled. Yeah, jumps forward with the unstable concoction. IX Mike in trouble. Radiant's not able to bring it down from the last day. Comes through and brings down the Alchemist. He'll pay with his life. Ends up being a 2-for-1 overall double kill, going the way of Justin's Void. And he's looking for more here. Jubei, under the cover of Vendetta, though, will be able to just back himself away.
Have you just seen what IX Mike has bought?
Oh, God.
I mean, okay, right. That fight was, you know, like, great setup by Complexity. I think the Tinker did a hell of a lot of work, though. You know, gets in, blinks into the trees, is untargetable, no way that Complexity can actually find him. Just lays down March and rocket spam, and they do kill the Alchemist, which is great and all. But Rod of Atos, Batrider.
Yeah, I don't know. I have no comment, really. I'm a scrub, so there's no way I can think to the point where I can understand this item choice. And that, not that it's a bad one, but I just really don't see the implications in this game. You've got so much initiation potential with the Batrider and the Nyx. It feels like maybe damage.
It's the pop Lincolns.
Okay. Sure.
That is like...
There it is.
That is like the only reason you buy that item nowadays is to put... Look, straight away, IX Mike is like, fuck you, Lincoln Sphere. I've got a Rod of Atos. They purge off the silence. Justin still takes a chunk of damage there as the Tinker does TP in, but blinks back away from the Legion Commander's nuke.
Why not Yules in that case against the Legion Commander and a Void? I don't know.
I'm unsure.
Or staff is a Batrider item. That's good as well, right? I guess you can blow it from such range with the Atos.
It is
like 3,000 units almost. So it's not terrible. It works. Jubei infested, finds the Alchemist, but cancel gets the chemical rage off. It's gonna be a difficult kill. They use the spike carapace to initiate, but they miss the impale. Now the real kick coming through. Moo's gonna find the duel. BSJ, whether he dies in the duel or not, is going down. He will get damage from it.
Oh, the single chrono with the silencer. Okay, well, they've got that kill for sure. Swindles gets a double. And in the back, Batrider TPs away, and Tinker looks like he's okay as well. But, oh man, Freedom was so hungry for that Alchemist kill. They blew a lot, but you're going in 2v5, right? You know there are multiple heroes from Complexity around that tier 1. They are defending that tier 1 with pretty much all their force. If you find the Alchemist without his chemical rage, then sure, you can probably kill him, but I don't know. It's a tall order to actually go for that. Z-Freak walks into March, keeping his creep alive at least for a little bit longer, but ballsy play there by him as now Blink Dagger for Justin. Increase that initiation range from Complexity. Tinker, he's still got his Blink Dagger, and he actually jumps forward into Z-Freak and Moo. They've got a duel available. They blink forward, but there's the Global still killing off the Tinker. Jubei hunting. The Nyx Assassin hiding in the Vendetta just behind. Will they be able to find Z-Freak here? That's the question. It's level 1 Vendetta. He's got 4 points of stun, but only 1 in the mana burn.
I don't think they should fight this without Tinker. Would be extremely
there's
risky.
There's no Chemical Rage for 14 seconds. They're going to go into the Lifestealer. They've got a lot of damage. There's no Armor Toggle just yet. Cancel turns it on now. They've not got the burst quite yet, and he does finally go down. But the question is, how many do they lose for the insolence of trying to kill off Cancel, and the answer is 5. 5 for 1. They kill Alk. Great. Good job, Freedom. Well done. You have defended your lands. You have defended your lands.
Moo got a duel on the bottom side to IX Mike, initiating on the Batrider, of course. Without IX Mike having something like a, you know, Yule's Force Staff, Blink Dagger, it's going to be very difficult for him to get the jump over Moo's Legion Commander. And they're able to initiate the fight that way, even though their Alchemist was gone on Diabolic level 4, Swindles here up on the high ground. Tier 3 melts to the ground. And already, 22 minutes in, and we've seen this story before in Dota Pit just a couple days ago, Complexity looking at high ground here 20 minutes in, but looks like Freedom may live to fight another day for the time being. Earn ticks, press the attack. Tether gonna try and help them on the extraction, and it looks like Freedom not gonna be able to punish them for leaving.
They have so much sustain behind them. Armlet on Moo, Wisp with Urn, and 3,000 gold apparently on Z-Freak.
Nice.
Where, he's just suddenly, he just suddenly like manifested cash out of absolutely nowhere.
11 assists will do that for you, I suppose.
It's like one of these American banks. Printing money.
And they still have Chronosphere. After all said and done, in that top lane fight, they don't even end up using it. So Complexity, this game is well within their reach at this point. And Freedom, they're going to go for a little bit of a desperation move. They're lacking on experience, lacking in gold. They need some sort of key target to go their way. And Cancel's a good one to find if they can find him. IX Mike, going to be able to find him. Atos is there. They'll be able to sign him up with the Carapace, off the Radiance, Flame Break, a couple more right clicks. And Cancel will end up dropping bottom lane. 700 gold is going to go the way of IX Mike, which is a nice little bounty for them. But at the end of the day, their Lifestealer, he's really going to be, you know, aside from Teemo, their major source of damage into this Alk. They have to burst him down, of course, in the Chemical Rage.
Oh,
he's just
dear. Yeah, this is going to be a duel win as well, I think. Oh, the Global Silence is there, so they won't actually get it. But that's a Global to stop a duel. And now Justin just jumps on in with a duel down onto the Nyx Assassin. They should have more than enough damage to kill him off during. No, they don't. Flame Break buys just enough time. IX Mike with a little play there to stop the duel win. Yeah. But Ancient Black Dragon. Here come the Fireballs. Moo given the Lincoln Sphere by his teammate. He's got his armlet to toggle as well. And, well, I don't know. This dragon is going in deep as in the back end. In comes the stun. Hits onto one. Only into Batrider for IX Mike as Swindles goes 1v2. I think the rest of his team is looking to kill off the dragon and the lifestealer, though. Ah, Swindles, yeah, you are dead, my friend. BSJ tries to TP you away. They've got no duel, they've got no stuns, but they've got a bash from Justin to secure that. And again, they go for the Alchemist cancel kill. They lose a hell of a lot more than they bargained for.
And really, what does Cancel lose when all is said and done? He's back on the opposite side of the map, farming away, shoving in waves, and his team's dealing with Freedom 5v4. So this is dire straits at this point for the dire side as BSJ. I mean, he just feels like really a non-factor in these fights. He did just pick up his Desolator before dying, so gets a little bit of extra burst potential. And if there's a chance they can initiate onto a target like Z-Freak, maybe even the Void, since they're able to pop his Lincoln Sphere, that would be huge for them in a team fight. But Teemo once again almost gets caught out towards the mid lane. He is able to blink out as he doesn't get bashed during the rearm there, and he refreshes his blink in between right clicks.
Justin playing so aggressively on this Void, and BKB for Moo, Diffusal Nair done for the Faceless Void. Jubei's going on a little bit of a wander here, doesn't have the Lifestealer inside of him, so needs to find one of the simpler targets, but pretty sure he was spotted there, just walked into the sentry range barely, and a little bit of vision remaining for Cancel. Will see the Nyx walk on in as the scan comes out, just to make damn sure the Nyx isn't hiding around anywhere here, but Freedom have backed up into their own jungle. And
I mean, what's his opening? We alluded to it in the draft. Nyx behind on levels is not really a great hero, and he's literally the bottom of the barrel sitting on level 11, even under Z-Freak's level 12 Wisp, who has a mechanism. So without the Lifestealer, he has no kill potential, and even with the Lifestealer, it is going to be difficult, especially considering Cole's current positioning up on the high ground, grouped nearly as five as they have been the whole game.
With a tier one
to the side farming. Yeah. Tier 1 still available as well.
Oh, they might find Z-Freak here, though. Global Silence is there. Oh, they Vendetta and then blink away, scared of what was coming. And Z-Freak will finally fall, but in comes the Chrono onto two. Nyx and Batrider both caught out. They can look for the duel onto Eel in the backside, but, well, in comes the stun, the duel, and the damage from Complexity. Once more, they find one kill, and they lose several heroes of their own. I'm not sure this has been worth it for Team Freedom, as the 23-13 scoreline really does indicate Cancel just stands in the creep wave, stands in the march. The rest of his team pounds into tier two.
Yeah, and already Araxes exposed top lane. I mean, they are a little bit bloodied at this point, but Justin gonna jump forward, gets to press the attack off, will be able to time walk away. So because of their condition, not gonna be able to touch high ground. But I mean, that wasn't even an ideal scenario for Complexity. The chrono hits and there wasn't any real immediate follow-up. It just kind of served to hold the Freedom heroes in place, and then Complexity able to set themselves up as it expired, get off a dual win. They clearly have more than enough damage now to fight. And again, we've been seeing this time and time again without Cancel pressing. So once they are going to look at high ground, they are going to have their full artillery available to them. And Cancel, I mean, he's got the Manta on top of the Radiance and the Armlet, 2,600 gold. He can just finish up a pipe if he wants to help them with the high ground siege, considering that they already have mech and drums on Z-Freak and Swindles, respectively.
Oh, Justin snipes the courier, and now time walks away, but can't really get himself too far away without the help of the Wisp, who relocates him out. In comes the Alchemist now. The lasso's down onto Mu, and this actual duel not going to do too much, but the held BSJ in place for long enough so he can't infest. And this time, Freedom get nothing for their worries, as Jubei is the last one standing, and a godlike streak continues there. As, 11-1 Faceless Void. But like you're saying, with this Alchemist, it feels like he's just a damage sink. He's just a gank tanker. He walks around the map and says, "Hey, come and kill me!"
And everyone else is farmed as crap. I mean, Mu Chrono gonna whiff, trying to find the invisible Jubei, but they get him anyways with the Diffusal Blade and press the attack for the extra right clicks. With the styling time walk at the end, Justin, beyond godlike streak. And second lane of Rax looks going to be another sub 30 minute win. The third one in three matches between these two teams going the way of Complexity. And yeah, as you mentioned, I mean, we say that mid lane, immediately they relocate out the Void. So again, it was 4v5, but Cancel was there to replace Justin's Void for that fight. And still, fight's not going completely ideal. Complexity still finding wins. It just shows how far ahead they were in this game.
Well, let's see if Complexity can continue their flawless victories over over Team Freedom. I think in the past, like, four times they've met in best of threes, they've only dropped, like, one game or something.
Right.
They've not been doing too well at Freedom, but, of course, one more game at the very least to come up here. Best of three, game number two, will be happening after a short break for the ESL 1 Genting qualifiers, as we see in a little bit.
We'll be right back. Get your team apparel now at shop.eslgaming.com.